Grandmaster Poi showing us all, I think, if we hearken back to thousands of years ago, how invincible those Chinese infantrymen could be with simply a short sword and the shield used effectively. Just ahead, our main attraction of the evening, Cung Lee against Jason Yi. With more on that, the man who will call the bout once again here at our Kung Fu Championships, Spencer Ross.
And there is an air of excitement here as they await Jason Yi, who has been out of competition, out of active fighting, except for his own martial arts school in Boston for the last 3 years. He comes back at the age of 29 years of age to step into the ring, moving up in weight classification and going up against the champion, Cung Lee. And we take a look at Jason Yi as he gets ready for tonight's battle against Cung Lee. And Paul Kennedy takes a look at 29-year-old Jason Yi.
Jason Yi, Kung Fu extraordinaire, a champion of Kung Fu forms, weapons, and fighting.
A staggering kick almost knocked him out.
Hailing from Boston, Jason began studying Kung Fu at the early age of 6.
You know, ever since I threw that first kick, that first punch, you know, I knew that this is what I wanted to do the rest of my life.
In 1988, Jason wanted to train with the best, so he went to the source. He went to China. Returning to the States, Jason was on the road to gold, winning several national championships.
Competing is the ultimate challenge. I mean, either you win or lose, you know, but the ultimate challenge is actually competing with yourself, you know, getting up every day and just doing it.
In 1991, Jason earned his international reputation in Beijing, China, where he became the first American to medal at a world championship. Even more remarkable, Jason was the only competitor to compete in both forms and Sancho.
What drives me is achieving the goal, you know, and the goal is winning.
This versatile athlete returned to the States and took the Nationals by storm, winning 3 all-around titles in forms, weapons, and fighting. In 1993, Jason was voted into Inside Kung Fu's coveted Hall of Fame. The following year, Jason captured the super middleweight title with finesse and power, knocking out 3 champion fighters.
What makes me keep going is just the fire, the sense of accomplishment, the satisfaction of knowing that I've, you know, given it my all.
And in 95, Jason hung up his gloves to coach, producing several national champions.
Well, at that point in my career, I achieved what I wanted to do, and I saw my next challenge would be coaching.
Well, Jason is up against this young man. 4 years, Jason's junior, Cung Lee, has also produced several national champions at his martial arts school in San Jose, California. He continues to fight. He has strength, he has power, he has confidence, and he is looking to maintain his title as light heavyweight champion. He is 5'10", 175 pounds. He was born in Saigon and now lives in San Jose, California, and there's no doubt that Cung Lee is a champion.
Cung Lee, the technician, skilled in Sancho, Muay Thai, Russian and Greco-Roman wrestling, and Taekwondo. Hailing from San Jose, California, Cung began training in freestyle wrestling in the 8th grade. By 1990, Cung captured state and national championships in Sambo, Greco-Roman, and freestyle wrestling. Being a hungry competitor, Cung needed a new challenge, and he found it in Kung Fu.
I'm always looking to challenge myself and push past my limits, so my punching, kicking, sweeping, and wrestling takes it to a whole new level.
With a tremendous appetite to learn and a thirst to win, Cung went to the Sancho Nationals in 1994. In his first ever Sancho competition, Cung exploded onto the scene, capturing the light heavyweight division with an arsenal of hard throws and heavy blows. As captain of the U.S. team, Cung medaled at the World Championships too in 1995. Since then, Cung has dominated the field as a national champion, an extraordinary 3 years in a row.
For me, conquering myself is my main goal, and you know, being a complete person is, you know, the highest achievement that I can get.
Being a versatile athlete, Cung has competed outside the Sancho Arena. Last year in Las Vegas, in a stunning win, Cung took the Black Belt League's International World Championship in continuous sparring, and recently competed in Chicago's Shotokan Championships.
Every time you step in the ring, there's that element of surprise. You never know what's going to happen. So in that area, I just look up to, you know, the Lord and ask Him to protect me from all injuries, protect my opponent from any serious injuries, and I just take it from there.
Cung has become the new leading force in Sancho, remaining undefeated in the national championships. Celebrated for his unstoppable determination, Cung Lee is a true world-class fighting champion.
I train like a champion, I win like a champion, and if I lose, I'll lose like a champion.
And we are ready for the fight we have all been waiting for. Jason Yi against Cung Lee. A look at Jason Yi, who is set to enter the ring. Jason Yi, at the age of 29, his first appearance in active competition in 3 years. 1974 was his last fight. The layoff, Bruce Fontaine. What might it do?
Actually, I spoke to him about this fight and how he's preparing, and he actually told me in the years that he's been off, he has not actually stopped his training. He has stopped competing, but he stepped back from competition to train people like Rudy Ott, who we saw earlier. Now he really wants to come out seeing a formidable opponent in Cung and show the world the best of Sancho.
And his opponent, Cung Lee, who, to get ready for this, he's worked with boxing and wrestling coaches. He's 25 years of age. He'll fight a little southpaw tonight. He said he's going to turn around and perhaps try and confuse Jason Yi. Has that lethal scissor kick, and he's got a following indeed.
He certainly has a following. You can see the audience. They're going crazier tonight. They're actually up in the stands. I mean, you can feel the anticipation in the air. I think this is going to be a very exciting fight.
We're ready for the big one, the fire and the fury. It's Jason Yi against Cung Lee, and Mark Biro, as the crowd is on its feet, will introduce the competitors.
Live from the Marriott World Center in the Magic City of Orlando, Florida, the MaxNet Entertainment Group Incorporated, in association with Jeff Bolt, Johnny Lea, and Max Yoffe, presents the 1997 Kung Fu Championships main event, The Fire and the Fury. It is scheduled for 5 2-minute rounds for the Kung Fu Light Heavyweight Championship. Ring officials assigned by the Wushu Kung Fu Federation, your president, Anthony Goh, vice president, Jeff Bolt, sitting judges at ringside are: from Gaithersburg, Maryland, Joe Dunphy; from North Beach, Maryland, Gary Utterback; from Austin, Texas, David Pinkins; from Columbus, Ohio, Rocky Byers; and from Daphne, Alabama, Craig Strong. Your chief referee in attendance at ringside, from mainland China, now living in Mobile, Alabama, Sean Liu. Your center referee for this event, also from mainland China and hailing from Seattle, Washington, Michael Lee. Here now are the contestants, beginning first in the black corner to my right, wearing the black trunks, white trim. He weighs in at 173 pounds. He hails from Boston, Massachusetts. He is the first American to win a medal at Beijing's World Championships and a member of the prestigious Inside Kung Fu Magazine's Hall of Fame. Here is the super middleweight champion and challenger, Jason Kung Fu Extraordinaire Yi. black trunks with gold and red trim. He weighs in at 175 pounds, hailing from the former Saigon, South Vietnam, and now making his home in San Jose, California, a two-time U.S. National Gold Medalist, a three-time U.S. Open Gold Medal winner, the Kung Fu Lightweight Champion of the World, Cung the Technician Lee! 5 2-minute rounds for the Kung Fu Light Heavyweight Championship.
Gonna be quite a battle. Jason Yee from Boston, Massachusetts, goes against Cung Lee, who was born in Vietnam, came to the United States in 1975. Jason Yee, who was born and raised in Boston, and then he went to the Orient to learn and study in China. And now they'll go 5 rounds, 2-minute rounds, with a light heavyweight championship on the line, Bruce Fontaine.
That is correct, 5 rounds. Unlike the 3 rounds of each of the fighters before, we're gonna have 5 rounds of excitement tonight. I guarantee you, we're gonna see something exciting.
Well, Cung Lee, as he told me, he said he's gonna come out southpaw, and he does exactly that. And a good kick right there.
You know, I spoke to Cung about any special strategy, or was he gonna try anything new, and he didn't tell me about the southpaw. Maybe he's been trying to keep that a secret. Afraid that maybe I might leak it to Jason.
He gave me a wink. He told me, I'm coming out southpaw. Don't say a word to Jason. I did. Oh, cool. Oh. Takedown. Big takedown by
Very
Cung
good takedown.
Jason having trouble getting inside here in the early going. Must be patient.
I think they're really feeling each other out. They both, I'm sure, respect each other. Actually, they've told me they both respect each other as fighters. I think they're mixing it up now. Nice takedown.
Grabbed the leg and brought him down.
Brought him down. Well, you know, as it was mentioned earlier to the viewers, Cung Lee is actually a wrestling champion in many forms of wrestling. Sambo, Greco-Roman wrestling and freestyle wrestling. He's using that to his advantage.
By the 8th grade, he was a freestyle wrestler. At the age of 10, he began the study of Taekwondo.
Oh! I think Jason was trying to turn the tables with the wrestling takedowns there.
Round 1 of 5. Cung Lee with his back to you now. Jason Yee faces you.
You know, I got to say one thing about Jason. I got to give him credit because when he accepted this fight, he actually got ill with chicken pox. When he was recovering, he got back. He decided, that's it. I'm going to keep to my guns. I'm going to fight this fight. When he recovered, he just went right back into training.
Went right back into training and now having trouble finding his corner. And as he goes back to the black corner, that is a very, very tough illness to hit you when you reach the age of 28. He's 29 now. He's in fine physical condition. He's gotten through the first round. The edge perhaps went to the man in the other corner, Cung Lee.
Okay, they're going to go in the corners and listen to the fighters.
So watch the edge a little bit. You're backing up now.
Okay. All right, here we've got some playback of the takedowns.
And that's a beauty.
Beauty.
Strength.
Okay, now we got another takedown. They're exchanging blows.
Now what did Jason do wrong to set this one up?
Jason did not recoil his kick quickly enough. It allowed Cung the opportunity to catch a leg and drop him.
So we're ready for the second round now. Cung Lee. On
He's
the
got
right,
some supporters
Jason
out
Yee
there.
On the left. Oh yeah. Students from the school wear T-shirts that say "Oosh USH" on the front, and on the back of the T-shirt says "Oosh," the sound you hear before the lights go out.
Oh, Jason almost came right into our stand there.
Yeah, 3 points too for Cung Lee for taking him off the late tie.
You know, there's a bit of an irony about this fight tonight. Cung Lee is qualified for the next U.S. National Wushu team, which will go to Rome in November. Jason has actually been named to be the coach.
Interesting.
Rather ironic.
Whoop, whoop. They got him off. That's 3 points.
3 points.
In 1995, Cung Lee won the bronze medal at the World Championships. First American ever to do that.
No correction there. Cung Lee won the bronze medal. But
bronze
prior
medal.
In 91, Jason actually won the bronze medal and was the first American to win it in Sancho. Cung Lee is actually training very hard, he told me, and he wants to take the gold in the next World Championships.
It comes up in November in Rome.
Correct.
Second round, scheduled for 5.
We're coming down on 30 seconds. They're feeling each other out, they're waiting for that opening.
Remember, Jason Yee had a come up on weight class.
Oh,
right
hit
to the head right there. Second round, about to be history of this 5-rounder.
And this fight is going to be a historical event, I'm sure.
Cung Lee back into his corner.
Okay, and they're taking this into the
corner. Spit it out. Right on the side.
See Jason's lips, no problem, he said.
Yeah. We've got some supporters in the audience for Jason there, and they're starting to voice it. All right, we've got a nice kick coming up here. Cung just timed it right. Set up with a punch. Another punch. Open him up, just caught him right with that roundhouse kick. That has got to sting.
Third round of the scheduled 5-rounder.
You know that kick we just saw? It can cost you a lot of money in dental work if one of them lands just right.
That's why referee Michael Lee checked. Do you have your mouthpieces in, gentlemen?
It's a good thing
for
the mouthpieces.
What strength right there by Cung Lee. He was off balance, about ready to get thrown out of the ring, and he was able to battle back.
Yeah, he centered himself, brought his weight down, and Jason just didn't have enough strength and leverage to get him up. He just barely evaded that kick. Yeah.
Cung Lee, his family back home in San Jose, watching this on pay-per-view. That's a three-pointer. Got Jason Yee out off the late tie. A 24 by 24 foot mat.
You know, one thing I think Jason's got to do is he's standing close to the edge of the late tie or the platform, and Cung is just taking advantage of that.
Jason got a good right hand in there too, Cung did as Jason was turning away.
You know those kicks to the back of the legs, they can really sting after a while and makes it hard for you to stand up.
Most things done in this ring by these very talented gentlemen would make most people have difficulty in standing up for very long.
No argument from me. You know, most of my fighting has been on film. I would not want to be in there right now.
Operation Condor with Jackie Chan. You can see my partner here, Bruce Fontaine, and that.
But the real excitement is here tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And the end of the round.
The third round is over. Two rounds to go, and thus far, Jason Yee finds himself behind in this fight, I would say, at this particular point.
Certainly, I think he's a little bit behind.
You see Rudy Ott, who fought earlier in his corner, giving some instruction.
Rudy's very much his protege and also a big supporter. I wonder what's going through his mind right now. All right, here, we've got that flurry. Now, Cung was actually getting a little more daring. I think he's getting confident, tries a spinning back fist, comes in, pushes him right off the stage. I think he's showing his confidence there, trying something a little more daring. When you do one of those spinning back fists, if your time is not quite right, oh, here we have another combination. And a takedown.
Two rounds to go. Kung Lee on the right. With the gold stripe down his trunks against Jason Yee with the white stripe down his trunks.
I think Jason might have taken a shot to the groin there. My angle, I couldn't catch that, but he seems okay to come back.
Jason in trouble right here. Cung Lee on the attack, gets it off the late tie for three more points.
And it looks like we got a little bloodletting there.
Oh, right kick.
I think the audience might get in a fight here. You've got Cung Lee supporters cheering, and then you've got Jason supporters cheering. It's hard to know what's gonna happen.
The whole object, ooh, that's a kick right to the back of the leg.
Like
the
I said, those sting.
The whole object of martial arts, though, does not allow for that type of situation to develop.
No, good, not at all. That. Like I said, these men are really very sportsmanlike. They're serious professionals. They're really good athletes. They love what they do, and they work hard, and they devote a lot of their life to it.
Both these young men operate their own martial arts schools. Jason Yee in Boston, Cung Lee in San Jose, California. Good right hand by Cung Lee. Fourth round about completed. And the favorite, no doubt about it, Cung Lee has lived up to the billing as favorite.
Yeah, he was
one round to go.
He was certainly the favorite going into this, but you know, Jason, he's an experienced veteran. I think, you know, he could still really pull it off. He told me that his most memorable moment was knocking out Alvin Bailey. You know, he may just do it again tonight.
He's going to need a knockout when he wants to win this one.
Yeah, when he knocked out Alvin Bailey, that actually gave him his super middleweight champion title. I think he'd like to capture this title. Jason is a very determined athlete. He's been involved in many aspects of the martial arts. He's been a champion in forms, a champion in weapons.
Only American ever to win championships in both as far as competition and weapons and form.
Yes, correct.
Yeah, take it to him. All right, Jay, let's do it.
Final round. They'll come to the center. Referee Michael Lee brings them together.
I don't know if you caught that expression on Kung's face there, but he looks like he's ready to turn it on.
And he picks up three more points, letting Jason Yee know you need a comeback, but I don't think you're going to get it tonight.
You never know. Again. You could turn it around, but... Oh, there's that scissor takedown that he's known for.
The scissor kick that Cung Lee is famous for utilized to perfection right there.
I think he was holding that back for this last round. Building to the climax.
Not only is that points, but But there's a right hand that takes Jason down. But that scissor kick just emotionally and psychologically had to have taken Jason Ige out of the fight.
Yeah, I know. He's been taken down with the scissor takedown. I think he's a little bit shaken emotionally. You know, Cung came in looking real strong and confident. Jason, you know.
And that right hand more than psychologically, physically.
Yeah.
Might have just almost put an end to this fight.
He's only got, like, he's just coming up on 30 seconds shortly. He's got to turn it around if he wants to win this night, because I have the feeling they're going to go for Cung. He's fought a strong fight.
He's dominant fight. Yeah.
And there we go.
Right there. That's the what a finish. What a climax to a marvelous performance by a great champion against a great champion.
He's been saving the best for last, I tell you. These are techniques that he's known for, and he's been saving the best for last. There we go. Scissor takes him off the stage.
For three
gets
more
3 points.
And that'll do it.
That is the end of it.
It is over. 5 rounds.
You know, Jason, he fought a good fight, but I think it's apparent to everyone here that the champion is, in fact, Cung. I mean, I have full admiration for both these gentlemen. Jason, I've known for some time. He's a tremendous athlete. But
two scissor kicks in that final round. Two scissor kicks. The reverse takedown.
Yeah.
A great champion with a great performance. And Jason
Yee,
who
came up
and
waited. I think he's got a bit of a performer in him. He was saving those things, building to the climax.
And Jason Yee, who came out of retirement for this fight.
I think that Jason showed that he's a tremendous athlete here. He fought a good fight. He's done very well.
And the judges are tabulating their points right now. Mark Biron ready in the center of the ring. And he's ready to find out if the judges are ready.
Judges ready. Judges ready. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner in Kung Fu light heavyweight champion, the red corner, Cung the Technician Lee.
I gotta say, that was an exciting fight. I really enjoyed that. You know, I wasn't sure when it came on, really who would be the winner. I know that Jason was real hard, and I thought it could have gone either way.
Great performance.
There's that scissor takedown that he's known for. Cung is quite the athlete. And here we go. Knockdown.
Well, the crowd got what they expected. They got a great performance by two great champions. Jason Yee right alongside right here.
You know, I'm glad I went the distance with the champ. I mean, I was stepping up from super middleweight, and meeting a light heavyweight. And I just want to say, Mom, I love you, and I'm still here. I'm alive. But my team was here, and you saw, you know, all the guys from Boston were mine, and they did their thing, you know. You know, I'm still walking out with my pride.
Congratulations, a great effort. Jason Yee, and let's get Cung Lee in here. Cung, you told me you're going to come out southpaw. You came out southpaw. You saved the best for last, though, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. I knew he was going to be, you know, quick, and he was lighter, but I think by putting on the weight, he kind of, you know, wasn't... You know, the difference in power was a little, probably too much for him. He hasn't competed in 3 years, so I give him a lot of credit for, you know, coming out and doing his best. You know, he had his game plan, but as soon as he got hit with the power, you know, he just kind of his game plan changed, and that was my whole game plan, to just set him off his game plan and do what I do best. So
well, a great performance, great theatrics at the end with a couple of scissor kicks. The crowd loved it, and your whole team behind you with great support. Congratulations.
Oh, real quick. First of all, I would like to thank my two trainers.
Okay, we got to get this off quickly.
Okay. Giovanni, Ellen, and everyone here. They put their body on the line.
Okay, great performance by Cung Lee, who maintains his title. And right now, let's get back over to Paul Kennedy.
All right, Spence and Bruce, plenty of oosh in that Cung Lee corner. And I guess here at the Kung Fu Championship, it should have been no surprise that a man named Cung prevailed. But Jason Yee, give him a great deal of credit, retired for 3 years, comes out of retirement. We remind you, this is for Jason the very first defeat of his Sanshou career, and it came here tonight against the four-year younger man in Cung Lee. Well, that'll do it. We certainly have enjoyed the pleasure of your company here this evening at the Marriott Orlando World Center. Tonight, indeed, the center of the Kung Fu universe. For Jim Carvelis and Nick Grayson, who presented us tonight with weapons and forms, and of course our Sanshou broadcast trio tonight, which included Cynthia Rothrock, Bruce, and Spence, I'm Paul Kennedy. For our entire broadcast team, a good evening to you throughout the United States. This has been the 97 Kung Fu Championships, and tonight the feature attraction, Wong by Cung Lee.